It's the Power Hour. Hour number three of the Doug Stewart Show. Doug Stewart Show. I haven't sung for y'all in a while. I really need to sing this song here. Right up my alley. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show, the realest, truest sports and guy talk show in America. Yeah. Welcome back to the show, man. January 3rd, 2017. We're paying tribute to the great new addition. We talked earlier about USC getting it done last night over Penn State. Speaking of Penn State, Michigan, and Ohio State all losing their bowl games. Pac-10 ain't squat. Well, the Big Ten, I'm sorry. The Big Ten ain't squat. What else do we touch upon? Nick Saban telling Lane Kiffin to get to steppin' and don't cut the corners. Kirby Smart doing it big in Georgia. So far, we'll see. And one quick story, man. You know what? I'll hold that story. When we get back from the break after this segment, I want to talk quickly about, who Vegas is liking in the NFL playoffs. But I want to read some messages in the chat room on Spreaker.com. We're going to read more chat this year. That's something else we're going to do. From Clay Jody Baby Davis, he says, I'm really looking forward to FSU versus Bama in the Falcons' new stadium. Yeah, so the first game in the new, the Mercedes-Benz Dome here in Atlanta for the Atlanta Falcons is going to pit FSU versus Bama in the ACC-SEC Challenge game, I think they call it. So that's going to be good. Yeah, it's going to be very interesting, man. The whole Georgia thing, man, and tearing down a perfectly fine building, man, I just think it's a big waste. You know, when you drive around Atlanta, I've made these comments before, but just because we're talking about the Georgia Dome, if you ride around Atlanta, man, under some of these bridges, man, you see like whole camps of homeless people. And you're going to knock down a perfectly fine building structure and put up a whole new one just so you can sell more luxury boxes? And there's people that are hungry? I just don't like the idea of it, period. I mean, I don't like the idea of fans playing for a billionaire stadium, first of all. And then when you add on top of it, there's nothing wrong with the Georgia Dome. Is it as nice as Jerry World? No. Is it as nice as some of the newer stadiums in the NFL? No, but it's perfectly fine. And they are going to knock it down and use that space for parking and build it right next door, a brand new structure, which I think is like $2 billion? $2 billion, and every time you ride around and somebody sleep underneath a bridge? I don't like that shit. I don't like that. I don't like that. That just don't set well with me, man. So it's going to be interesting, man. It's going to be fun to see and to go in there and check out all of the amenities or whatever, man. I just don't like it, period. And man, they charge you something crazy to get a seat. Obviously, because they got to pay for the damn thing. Sensational remakes news every year for drunk behavior on CNN. Okay, talking about Don Lemon. I think I read that earlier. From Tiffany Poole in Portland, go to the meeting with the commoner. Be back soon. Jeesh, they're all sick too. Yuck. From 334 Bama Boy, I said the same thing when I was in ATL this weekend. Yeah, it's very intriguing to see, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, when you go down to the Georgia Dome, it's very intriguing to see $1 billion building, that's fine. You know, everybody's watching the game in there. They had the whole season there. There's nothing wrong with it structurally. You know, it's not like the Orange Bowl or something like that, or Yankee Stadium, the original Yankee Stadium, where it was just old and outdated and beat up and it was a health risk or whatever. There's nothing wrong with it. And this right next door, literally about 50 yards away or 100 yards away, they're building this multi-billion dollar structure. Oh, yeah, and the taxpayers of Atlanta help pay for it. And the owner that's getting this building is a billionaire, Arthur Blank. It just don't sit well with me. I'm Tiffany Sports and Eels. Ty, I know you are a colonizer and you think we all sound alike, but Doug cannot sing. What? Hey, Tiffany, first of all, something must be wrong with your hearing, young lady. Second of all, Texas Ty is a former music producer. Outside of Texas Ty, there's no one else in this chat group that can give a better commentary about singing than Texas Ty. Thank you, Texas Ty. Tiffany, I thought we had made up. I thought we had kissed and made up virtually. You know, online. You know, I thought we had made up. You had started this little movement, you know, about Woman Wednesday, and we came to some type of agreement, and we moved on, and now you're back on that bullshit. Come on now. Don't do this. Don't do this in 2017, Tiffany. Don't do this. All right? Don't do this. Let's make 2017 peaceful. All right? You know good and well I can sing. You know it. Stop that. Stop that. From that ninja, he says, yes, Tiffany, stand down. Doug is a fabulous singer. Thank you, Ninja. Happy New Year to you, Ninja. Here we go. This is more like it, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show from Tiffany Sports and Heel. Doug, you know I love you. I was just playing around. You are the best singer that I've heard since Luther Vandross. Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Tiffany. From Angry Black Man, he says, the colonizer is telling the truth. Doug has a voice of an angel. Man, Angry Black Man, you being so angry, those are some nice words in 2017. Thank you, sir. From Lamont Hart, he says the Coliseum has been up since the 1930s. Yeah, I understand you making, like, updates. Like, you giving it some updates or whatever, rehabbing it a little bit. They always talk about the Coliseum out in California, man, and all of the history. And that's the good thing about sports I like, too. You know, I'm a traditionalist in a lot of this stuff. And, you know, to say that you played on the same field, like those cats last night that played in that game, can say that they played on the same field as O.J. Simpson. They played on the same field as Marcus Allen. They played on the same field with the great Charles White. A lot of y'all don't remember the great Charles White. Played running back for the Southern Cal Trojans. They played on the same field as Kenjana Carter. They showed Kenjana Carter last night, former Penn State running back, who was an absolute beast. He played in the Rose Bowl. So you can say that. The history aspect of it as well, I think, is cool. Like, you just tear down stadiums just to tear down stadiums just so you can get more money for your luxury boxes, man. I just think it's bootleg as hell, man. In this day and time, economic downturn, you know, people trying to survive. Once again, a lot of homelessness here in Atlanta. I just don't like it. Period. Simple as that. Let's see. From that ninja, he says, Penn State played a great game. All losses are not equal. Whatever, man. You Ohio State fan. Ain't nobody trying to hear what you guys say. Your team put up a goose egg. Ain't nobody trying to hear what you guys say. From Clay Jody Baby Davis, the new edition album is still fire. Yeah, it's fire. It would have been better with me. But it's still fire. They still can get it. They still get a lot of love. They do. All right, when we get back from the break, man, Vegas showing a lot of love. A lot of love to a particular NFL team in the playoffs. We'll talk about it up next. Don't go away. Back in 3 minutes, the Doug Stewart Show.